Today, we're taking a look at the FCPX 3D Freeze Frame Megapack plugin from Pixel Film Studios. This plugin allows you to quickly and easily add 3D freeze frame effects like this. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. The FCPX 3D Freeze Frame Megapack includes over 190 presets and it's constantly being updated with more. The included presets cover a ton of different categories, including awards, corporate, cinematic, summer, wedding, and many more. All these are put together into one bundle at $376 value, all for only $29.95. And on top of that, if you use the coupon code SERGEPIXEL during checkout, you get an additional 30% off your purchase. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and see just how easy this plugin is to use. Select your clip you want to use for this effect and drag and drop it down into your timeline. Skim your clip, and with a skimmer over the frame you want to use, press Option F on your keyboard. This splits your clip with the skimmer and inserts a still image clip of the frame your skimmer was on. Move your playhead to the start of this freeze frame clip and open the Titles and Generators browser. Inside here, you'll find all the Pixel Film Studios Pro Freeze categories you get with this bundle. Select the category that best suits your clip and click on the preset you want to use for your freeze frame. Press Q to connect it to your timeline and ripple trim the freeze frame clip to the same length as your connected clip. Place your playhead anywhere over the clip. Make sure a title clip is selected and head up to the viewer. First thing we need to do is isolate our subject from the background by using a mask. Make sure edit mode is selected in the inspector. Zoom in on your viewer window and add control points around your subject. Make this mask as accurate as possible. If you accidentally add a control point in the wrong place, you can either press Command Z to undo it or hover the pen tool over the control point until it turns to crosshairs and drag the control point to the proper location. Continue adding control points until your entire subject is outlined. Click on your first control point to complete your mask. Next, in the inspector, use the mask control sliders to soften the mask to remove any sharp edges, and if necessary, use the position, rotation, and scale sliders to move your subject inside the frame. Once you're happy with the framing of your subject, deselect the Edit Mode checkbox in the inspector window. That's all you really have to do. Let your clip render out, and here's what the default effect looks like. But there's more. If you select the title clip in the timeline, up in the inspector window, there's a ton of parameters you can customize. First, let's change the text we see during this effect. Scroll down in the inspector window until you see the controls for the main title. Select the text inside this box and replace it with your own title. Do the same to the second line in the subtitle box. Next, let's change the colors of our character to better match the background colors. Scroll up to the colorize section and select the colorize checkbox. Click on the color square below it and select the eyedropper from the pop-up window. Let's use one of the orange shades from our background. Let's also increase the contrast amount to make our subject pop a little. Play around with these controls and make your freeze frame look exactly the way you want. Down at the bottom of the inspector window, you can also turn on or off foreground and background elements. Adjust the position and scale of each individual element and more to make this freeze frame preset your own. Here's our finished result. Now, there was a couple issues I ran into with this plugin, but the live support on Pixel Film Studios' website was very helpful in helping me resolve these issues. First, when you purchase this plugin, you get an email with a download link. When I downloaded and installed this plugin in Final Cut Pro, I was missing all but one of the included categories. When I reached out to live support, they informed me that since this is a bundle that includes a number of individual plugins, I'd have to download and install each one individually. For this, you have to go to their webpage, sign into your account, and click on the order number. This takes you to the page where you can download and install all the included presets. You can choose to download them all, or like me, you can pick and choose only the ones you might want to use. Another issue I ran into was missing foreground and background elements. In the example we used for this demo, instead of palm trees in the background, all I had was blank placeholders. Once again, live support was very helpful. Turns out, since I added off an external drive, this was an issue with my media location settings. If you run into this issue, to fix it, select your library in the media browser, and in the inspector, click the Modify Settings button for the storage locations. Here, make sure your motion content location is set to In Motion Templates folder. Once I change this, all my presets work perfectly. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, let me know by hitting the like button and in the comments below. If this plugin is something you're interested in, during checkout, make sure to use the coupon code SERGEPIXEL for 30% off your purchase, limited to the first 500 users. And a huge thank you to Pixel Film Studios for sponsoring this video and making cool plugins like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.